Hello kids, our today's topic is addition of integers. For addition of integers, we have two methods. Let's understand the first method, which is addition of integers on number line. You have used already this number line in your previous classes, but you have used it for positive integers only. So let's revise that first. For positive integers, we know for addition, we have to move always towards right. For example, if you have to add 2 plus 4, so first we will go towards 2 and then we will move 4 steps towards right, which will bring us to our answer 6. Similarly, for negative integers, we have to move towards left. Whenever we get a negative integer to add up, we always move towards left hand side. Let's see one example. Minus 5 plus minus 3. See students, whenever we are writing the negative integers, it is preferred to use brackets so that it is very clear that this is a negative integer. So let's solve this question. Minus 5 plus minus 3. So first we will see where is our minus 5. So yes, this is a minus 5. Now minus 3 is to be added. That means we have to move towards left 3 more steps. So 1, 2 and 3. So our answer will be minus 8. Let's take another example, minus 5 plus plus 3. Here I have changed the second digit only. Previously it was minus 3, now it is plus 3. Let's see what changes it makes. So first is a minus 3, so where is a minus 3? Yes, this is a minus 3. Now plus 3, as it is a positive integer, so we will move 3 steps towards right. So 1, 2 and 3. So this will bring us to our answer as minus 2. Let's take one more example, 6 plus minus 2. So first we will see where is our 6. So yes, this is our 6. Now as minus 2 is a negative integer, so we will move 2 steps towards left. So 1, 2, which will bring us to our answer as 4. Now let's take one more example, 4 plus minus 4. So where is our 4? Yes, this is our 4. Now minus 4 is a negative integer, so we will move 4 steps towards left. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. And our answer is 0. So students, from this we learn a new thing, that is additive inverse. Numbers such as plus 4, minus 4, plus 3, minus 3, when added to each other give the sum 0. These numbers are known as additive inverse. So here are some examples of additive inverse. Plus 3 minus 3, plus 7 minus 7, plus 11 minus 7, etc. Now our second method of addition is without number line. Without number line, how to add? Let's see. When you have two integers with the same sign, for example, 4 plus 4 and plus 2. As you can see, plus 4 and plus 2 both are positive integers. That means both have the plus sign only. In this case, you have to simply add up and put that sign only. So 4 plus 2 is your 6 and both are positive, so we will put a positive sign here. Okay. Similarly, if both the signs are negative, for example, minus 4 plus minus 2. Now here you can see both the integers are negative integers as they both have negative sign with them. So here also we will simply add both the 2s. Like 4 plus 2 is your 6, and now we will put the sign that the two integers are having, that is negative sign. Similarly, let's see one more example. Minus 6 plus minus 8. Now again we have both the integers as negative only, minus 6 and minus 8. So we will simply add them. 6 plus 8 is your 14. Now as they both have negative sign with them, so we will put a negative sign before 14 also. So our answer will be minus 14. Now this was the case when the signs are same, when both the integers have the same sign. Now what if they have the different signs? For example, one is negative and one is positive. Plus 4, minus 3. So in this case, as you can see, here is addition only, but we will not do the addition, we will do the subtraction. Okay. Please be very careful about this. In the cases where the signs are opposite, like one is having a positive sign and the other is having a negative sign, there we will not do the addition, we will do the subtraction. So 4 minus 3 is your 1. Now what sign will come with 1, positive or negative? This will depend on the sign of the greater integer. Like in this case, 4 is big and 3 is small. So 4, the bigger number is having the sign plus with it. So we will write plus sign with 1. Let's take another example, minus 5 plus minus 2. Plus 2. So again we have both integers with two different signs. One is your negative and one is your positive. So again we will do the subtraction in place of this addition. We will not mention it anywhere, but it is an imaginary. We have to do the subtraction only. So 5 minus 2 is your 3. Now sign, which sign we have to put? So if you see 5, among 5 and 2, which is bigger? Yes, 5 is bigger. Here we will not consider the sign, just the value. So 5 and 2, which is bigger? 5 is bigger. So we will put the sign which is 5 is having. So 5 is having a sign of negative. So we will put here negative only. So minus 5 plus 2 will be your minus 3. Let's see one more example. Minus 5 plus 10. Here also, if you see, one is a negative integer and the other, as it do not have any sign, that means it is a positive integer. So what we will do? We will do subtraction here. So 10 minus 5 is your 5. Now the sign comes, what will be the sign? So among 5 and 10, which is the bigger number? Yes, 10 is a bigger number. So what's the sign 10 is having? 10 is a positive integer, it is having an imaginary plus sign here. So we will simply add plus here. So minus 5 plus 10 will be your 5. So this was all about addition of integers. I hope it is clear to you all. Thank you.